77 years ago, Al Capone's henchmen murdered seven rival mobsters, gunned them down execution style.
Right here. The St. Valentine's Day Massacre gave Chicago that rat-a-tat-tat reputation we're still trying to live down.
In the roaring 20s, gangsters arrived as a result of three illegal activities: gambling, prostitution, and bootlegging, which was the illegal production of alcohol.
On January 29, 1919, Congress ratified the 18th Amendment. This amendment states that the distribution or production of alcohol is prohibited. The prohibition of alcohol will increase organized crime, especially in the Windy City of Chicago, where two gangs will appear.
The South Side Italian Gang was led by Al Capone, while the North Side Irish Gang would be led by George Bugs Moran.
Capone and Moran were at odds over the distribution of alcohol. This resulted in constant violence between the two gangs.
The massacre will take place at a warehouse in Lincoln Park. It will be the culmination of conflicts between Capone and Moran dealing with alcohol. It will all begin on the morning of February 14, 1929.
Capone had set up a shipment of whiskey to arrive at the warehouse. Capone had stationed two lookouts across the street. Capone had four men arrive at the warehouse at 10:30 a.m.
He set up the massacre so that he would be in Florida at the time of the event. For unknown reasons, Moran was not at the warehouse when Capone's men showed up.
Four of Capone's men will line up seven of Moran's men and begin shooting them down with Thompson machine guns.
The only initial survivor was Frank Kusenberg, who would later die from bullet wounds. The fake police then escorted the disguised gangsters into their police car.
There's something happening here. What it is ain't exactly clear. There's a man with a gun over there, telling me I got to.
The police would go on to charge John Scalise and Jack McGurn with the massacre.
For the time being, Capone will be unaffected by the incident, while Moran will begin to lose power of the North Side Irish Gang.
The incident brought much attention to Capone and his criminal ways. In 1931, Capone was charged with tax evasion and would spend 11 years in prison. These are the seven victims killed on the morning of St. Valentine's Day, 1929.